So we've got our Metrel 3155 multifunction test route. What are we up to today, Gordon?
We're going to check the RCD function that's in this Easee EV charger.
This is a three-phase charging unit, and we're going to test the RCD only during this test. We've done other videos, haven't we, in the channel?
We have, and if you're interested in the full gamut of tests on EV chargers, check out that video. It's in the eye above my head or in the screen at the end of the video.
We're going to do a single test, and we're going to test the RCD. Okay, I'm going to do an auto test. Oh, just there.
Does that mean it's easier for you, Gary?
Hopefully it's easier for me, because I've got a funny feeling it might be a little bit more difficult for you, because I've had an inspection of this Easee EV charging point. I can't find a reset button anywhere on it. So there's our main screen. It's already been populated with all the details that we need. However, if we press this button here, we can go in and change, say, the earthing arrangement or the line to protective earth that we're testing between. What are we testing between?
Okay, well, so on this test, we're gonna pick the L3 conductor.
Okay.
Obviously, we could select any of the others. Yep. We're not using the plug top to hook up to the tester here, because that doesn't allow us to select the different phase configuration.
However, in our previous video, we did use this, didn't we? Because it was a single phase unit that we were testing. So we're using the banana plugs on this one.
Okay.
Again, we could have changed that. So by clicking on there, we could have chosen one of the other line conductors to test between, but we didn't.
Okay. Okay. So I'm gonna plug in the A1532, which is this adapter specifically for EV chargers.
Okay.
Plug in there, and I'm gonna set it up as if the car's charging, so I'll change that to state C.
Okay.
And we should have some lights appear on there, indicating that all phases are present, and the chargers indicating that if there was a car plugged in, this would now be charging.
Okay, you've also set it to 32 amps. What's the 32 amps representing?
32 amp is the maximum that this charger can be set to for the circuit configuration we have.
So the breaker's rated at 32 amps?
Yeah, but check that other video out if you want to see how cleverly these chargers share the current between different charge points.
So all I've got to do now is hit my run button, okay. And I'm going to run through the sequence to test this. But obviously when it trips the RCD, Gordon's gonna have to reset it. So let's have a little play here. So we say yes to that box. Okay, so we should be off and running.
So what's that first test, Gary?
We are now testing the 1x the rated value of the RCD, the nominal rating of the RCD, and it's tripped.
We'll see then, we've got a red lightsaber to indicate that. Are you ready for the?
Reset it then.
I'll do the reset, Gary. Are you ready for this?
I'm ready.
Really complicated. There you go. And we're back in, ready for your next test.
Right. Second one's gone. So again, we've done it in both sides of the cycle, the positive and negative halves of the AC waveform. And we can reset it again. So if you, by pulling it out, it looks really difficult. You've got the hard end there, I see. And we go back in, and now we're doing it at 5x its value.
Okay. So this should be a quick,
yep,
quick time.
Less than 40 milliseconds. So as we go here in the first half of the cycle, 17.5, you need to reset it.
Reset it again.
And we're now in the negative half of the cycle. We go again.
So this test is limited by how fast the tester works and how quickly I can plug that lead in and out.
We know which one's slower. Okay, so we've got those two readings. We're now gonna be doing it half times. You'll probably get a little break now, so if you reset this one. So half its nominal value of current. So here we go. So it shouldn't do anything in these two tests. So as we go through the first one in the positive half of the cycle, we expect nothing to happen. Nothing's happened. It's now gone over. You haven't had to do anything. We're over to the negative half of the cycle. Nothing's happened now. We're now going to do a ramp test to see how many of those milliamps it needs to drop the RCD out. And that's about 25 and a half. Okay. You need to reset it. That was in the positive half of the cycle.
Red lightsaber again.
That's a quick reset, isn't it? So now we go on to the negative half of the cycle, doing a ramp test. Here we go. So what reading do we get now? Okay, so it's going to go all the way up to 25.5. Okay, reset it. The next test is going to put some DC into the circuit. Okay.
So this is the unique thing about RCDs that are built into EV chargers.
Yes.
That have this DC function.
Yeah, got to be.
And that's the expensive bit if you're going to buy one to put in the distribution board.
It is. So here we go. So now we're going to see how much of this DC current we're going to need. So it's going to climb up, similar to a ramp test. And at 5.4 milliamps of DC current, it activated, which is good, it's under the 6. So redraw it.
And again.
And we go once more. And we should then go into the other half. So here we go again. So you'll see the DC current start to rise up. and we'll see how much of that DC current is required in order to take out the RCD. So it's gone out this time at 5.1. Okay. What's really nice there is we've got a big green tick suggesting
that. I know you like a green tick, Gary.
All of those tests are correct. Wow, let's just take a little breath there. There was absolutely nothing difficult about that. The Easee kept its name going and didn't require any, you know, major effort to reset the RCD. A simple case, just removing it. And the results, Gordon?
The results, yeah, it's a pass, but it also shows that how powerful that auto test function is in the Metrel 3155 as well.
Is there anything also going on in the backstory for Easee?
Well, let's just clear the table off, Gary. We've been watched while this video was going on, and I'll show you more.
So while you've nipped off to get your laptop, I've got my glasses. I've got a funny feeling, Gordon, it's going to get technical now.
Well, I did all the technicalities in the last video, Gary, and one of the really technical things I had to do was make sure the colour on the screen here matched the colour of the cover on the charger.
So are you telling me the EV charging point here I'm looking at with a red cover on is actually the one just here?
That's it. And they're communicating via the mobile phone network at the minute. Could be Wi-Fi, but we're still on mobile phone network. You can see that there. And the status of that is exactly the same as the status of the charger I have here.
So if I was to trip this EV charging point now, you're telling me the status on the screen would actually change?
Well, let's see how fast that happens.
Let's have a look. Okay, so you're ready to go?
Play a button there.
Right.
Doing okay. The first test.
So that will trip.
It's going to trip.
So red currently that one, it's white on here. It's just gone red. It's just gone red. Wow. What else can it now tell you when you look through the system?
Okay, so what Easee done, you can interrogate the charge and find up to 60 different parameters from the current rating, what the network performance is like, even the temperature of the charger itself.
So you could do all of that diagnosis before going to site if you had a fault?
If you had a fault, yeah, you'd have a pretty good idea before going there what's wrong. And if I scroll down here, Gary, you've been incredibly naughty. Because he is in the activity register here.
Let me guess, it's had a few tests.
There's been a lot of ground faults as we've been making this video. Not that we're suggesting there's any problem with the charger itself. It's just that we're doing a lot of testing to learn about this procedure.
So not just an incredibly clever tester that we really like, but also the Easee and the back office, also a very sophisticated piece of software.
Yeah, huge. So let's just see how quickly that resets.
Okay, so I'm looking again. It's red. It's just gone. Yes. Wow. That is really quick, quick. So as always at eFIXX, we're always interested in your opinions. Are you currently installing EV charging points? Have you tested a lot of EV charging points? What's your feedback? What can you recommend to us? Maybe where we should be looking next. We'll be interested in your comments below, and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.